member for Surrey Green Timbers.
Honourable Speaker, yesterday the Minister chose willful blindness over accepting the problem, the lack of acute care beds in the Fraser Health region. However, looking at Fraser Health's report card tells the real story. At Surrey Memorial Hospital, close to 70% of emergency patients wait in the ER more than 10 hours to be admitted. Photo ops in a new building, but the same old emergency room waits, and now cuts to acute care beds. Give with one hand and take away with the other. Will the minister explain why the Liberal government is cutting 35 acute care beds at Surrey Memorial Hospital while 70% of patients wait and wait and wait for access to the emergency care they deserve?
Minister of Health.
Thank you, Honourable Speaker. Honourable Speaker, last week I was at Nanaimo Regional General Hospital, where there is a fantastic new emergency department with state-of-the-art electronic health records. And Honourable Speaker, I recall the member who asked the question at the grand opening of the Surrey Memorial Hospital, Honourable Speaker. She was there as we opened a brand new facility in Surrey in her riding.
That's members. Added.
The member from New Westminster was with us when we turned the sod on $258 million first phase of Royal Columbian Hospital redevelopment. Last week, the Minister of Transportation and I toured the Clinical Services Building, the $80 million addition to Royal Inland Hospital that's only one of two phases of a $400 million redevelopment of Royal Inland Hospital in Kamloops. In town after town after town in the province of British Columbia, we are investing in first-class healthcare facilities in British Columbia because that side never did, Honourable Speaker.
Surrey Green Timbers on a supplemental.
Thank you, Honourable Speaker. But it's not just Surrey Memorial. 63% of patients wait in the ER for more than 10 hours to be admitted to Peace Arch Hospital. At Chilliwack Hospital, it's 70%. At Abbotsford Regional Hospital, it's 68%. At Delta, Honourable Speaker, 3 out of 4 patients are waiting for more than 10 hours to be admitted to the emergency. Honourable Speaker, all the minister can talk about is bricks and mortar, while patients are left stacked in emergency rooms and lying for days in hallways. Will the minister tell this House what he's doing to fix the unacceptable waits for healthcare in the Fraser Health region and start by putting a stop to cuts to acute care beds?
Minister of Health.
Thank you, Honourable Speaker. Honourable Speaker, there's a reason that the member who asked the question was so enthusiastic about attending the opening of the new Surrey Memorial Hospital. It's because she didn't get to go to any openings when she was a member of government, Honourable Speaker. Speaker, her government did not build Abbotsford Regional Hospital, despite promising they were going to build Abbotsford
Members.
Regional Hospital. Honourable Speaker, it was her government that closed Shaughnessy Hospital. It was her government that closed over 3,000 acute care beds across the province of British Columbia. On this side of the House, we are building new facilities in Comox, in Courtney, in Kamloops, in Penticton. We finished in Vernon, in Haida Gwaii. The new Children and Women's Hospital in Vancouver, Honourable Speaker. Community after community after community is seeing investment in health care because nothing ever happened when those people across the aisle were government.